Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade and welcome to another tutorial in the JSON for GameMaker series. In the last tutorial, we talked about how you can import JSON data as structs and arrays. Now we're going to be talking about how you can export structs and arrays as JSON data. Unlike the last tutorial where we compared importing JSON data as either structs or arrays or maps or lists, I'm not going to do that here. But I still want to point out that GameMaker data needs to be designed to work as a JSON file. You have to design that data for translation. And this is true whether you are going to use JSON encode, the built-in function to translate maps and lists into JSON data, or JSON stringify, the new function in 2.3.1 that will translate structs and arrays to JSON data. For structs and arrays, you set up your data by making sure that the top level is either a struct or an array, and it can be both. If you're going to use JSON stringify. If you're going to use JSON encode, the top level has to be a map. You also need to make sure to only export valid data types, and you don't want to mix and match the struct and array format with the map and list format. You got to pick one or the other. Now there's a couple different valid data types. If you remember from the first tutorial on JSON, JSON data can be a string, a number, an array, an object, a Boolean, or null. GameMaker doesn't really deal with null, or at least it doesn't import it. So there's generally not a reason to export it, which leaves us with strings, numbers, and Booleans in orange there, which are the same regardless of which format you use, and then either arrays and structs or maps and lists. But I just want to remind everyone that maps and lists are not actual data types in GameMaker, so you must take extra steps to mark them as maps and lists. And this is part of what makes exporting arrays and structs as JSON data so powerful. You no longer have to take a bunch of extra steps to mark your data. It just works. So how do you export? Well, you'll use JSON stringify on a top level struct or array, or JSON encode on the top level map. And then you save that resulting string to a variable. Then you open a file and save that string to the file. Both of these functions, JSON stringify and JSON encode, return a single string without line breaks. But let's switch over to GameMaker and see a couple examples. So here we are in GameMaker, and again, I'm going to focus just on exporting structs and arrays. So I've created two different data structures here, one where the top level is a struct and one where the top level is an array, and they contain strings, Booleans, numbers, more arrays and structs, nested arrays and structs, and so on. If you want a more real life example, I have both a link up above and a link below to a video by Mathru on saving and loading in 2.3.1 using structs and arrays. I think it's really good and a great way to get another view on this same topic. But let's just run this in GameMaker and see what we get. All right, so here we are. We've run it, stopped it in the debugger. We have our top struct, my string, my number, my Boolean. We have an array. And then we have our struct with nested arrays, also have nested arrays, and our nested struct, which is in fact just empty. We didn't actually put anything in it. We also have our top array, which has a bunch of arrays, and also a struct with nested arrays and structs. And let's just save these. So I'm going to walk through the save function. So here we go. It's pretty straightforward and very similar to the prior save function that I walked through in the earlier exporting tutorial. The only difference is that much like the change to the import JSON function, now you have to pass in the function as well. But all it does is it opens a file, and then it writes to that file with script execute, taking the data that we passed in and the function or script that we passed in, and then saving it out. Because I'm passing in a struct and an array, I'm using JSON stringify. If this were a map, you would use JSON encode. It'll be the same for that. And then just to show that it's working, we can do two things. The first thing we can do is actually inspect our text file. So here they are. For me, they're located under my main drive, then under users, then under my username, then under app data, which is a hidden folder for me. So you have to display hidden folders, then under local, and then finally under the folder with the same name as this project. And that's for me on Windows. It's different on different operating systems. If you don't know where to find these files, look up information on the file system in the manual. But we can now inspect this data, and like I said, it saves it out as a single string with no line breaks. Now, for this much data, it's not that bad, still kind of annoying, but if it were a lot of data, you would want to put this into some type of JSON editor and have it format it for you so you could read it with line breaks. And just to show that this is working, we can now step through the next two lines and reload them, again using the import JSON function that we talked about last time. And we have our loaded array and loaded struct. We can compare them. They are indeed the exact same. They don't contain references to the same arrays, they're new arrays, but all of the data is exactly the same. As always, I would highly recommend that you follow along with this tutorial by creating some of your own data structures that fit with the JSON requirements and then exporting them as JSON files and reviewing them in a text editor. And I'd also recommend writing or getting your own JSON save or export function so that you can speed up that process as well. So in summary, if you want to export JSON data, you need to prepare it by making sure that the top level for at least JSON stringify is a struct or an array and only using valid data types. You can then turn it into a JSON string with JSON stringify and save that resulting string to a file. As always, the links in this video will be below, along with links to the source code and the slides themselves. And that's it. Thanks for watching.